Hello, my name is Lauren Izzo, and we are On Record. Elbit Systems recently published its third quarter results for 2020. The company's CEO, Bezalel Machlis, highlighted the improved operational performance, an almost $11 billion backlog, and the increased volume of business opportunities provide Machlis with confidence in the outlook for the company. A new compact satellite communications add-on called ElinkSat has been launched by Elbit Systems and was recently demonstrated during the British Army Warfighting Experiment 2020. The new system weighs less than 1 kilogram and interfaces with the ElinkSat software-defined radios. ElinkSat enables maneuvering forces to maintain robust and secured on-the-walk and on-the-move voice and data communication services over ranges of hundreds of kilometers. Instro Precision Technologies, a subsidiary of Elbit Systems in the UK, hosted a special visitor recently, British Member of Parliament Craig McKinley. During his tour, McKinley was presented with the company's electro-optic systems. Based in the town of Sandwich, the company employs almost 100 locals, many of them in highly skilled manufacturing and engineering roles. The fully operational site provides systems to the Royal Artillery Regiment, as well as the British Army's Ajax and Warrior armored fighting vehicles. Instro is also a key supplier to the British Army's Watchkeeper program in partnership with its sister company, UAV Tactical Systems. The United States Air Force has selected Elbit Systems of America to compete on joint all-domain command and control task orders. The technology aims to operate systems for a unified force across air, land, sea, space, cyber, and the electromagnetic spectrum. And the JADC2 IDIQ contract is for future task orders to develop and enhance the multiple integrated platforms. With this selection, Elbit Systems of America can compete for awards associated with developing the multifaceted system across all platforms and domains, leveraging its open systems design. For the first time, Universal Avionics InSight display system is being used in the Canadian aviation market. Mid-Canada Mod Centre recently completed the installation of the integrated flight deck solution on a Citation 7 aircraft. With repair costs on an aircraft of this age typically high, the flight deck enhances safety and extends the usable life of the aircraft with a modern cockpit. The work includes an extensive flight deck upgrade, in-flight connectivity, and obtaining additional certification. A SAR-6 patrol corvette, also known as the INS Magen, has embarked on the journey to its home port in Haifa, Israel. The SAR-6 corvette will be equipped with Elbit Systems' advanced electronic warfare suit, protecting them as they secure Israel's economic zones in the Mediterranean. The EW suit was developed in close cooperation with Israel's Ministry of Defense and the Israeli Navy. And it includes digital receivers, signal processing technologies, and analysis tools. The Israel Defense Forces have named Elbit Systems a winner of the Commander-in-Chief 2020 Innovation Award for its Brigade and Battle Group Mission Training Center. The award highlights its uniqueness, feasibility, scalability, and extraordinary contribution to the overall effectiveness of the IDF. The Innovation Training Center immerses commanders, headquarters staff, and two subordinate command levels in high-fidelity command situations and in actual battle zone territory. Since entering service with the IDF, ground forces diverted all field training to the new center. Until now, the facility has accumulated many hundreds of operational training hours with thousands of trainees, both in service and from the reserve. And that's all for this edition. I'm Lauren Izzo. Thank you for watching.